We've all been there, elbow falling off the armrest as we fall asleep.
To live up to their purpose and potential.
But it's one thing to snooze during a speech and another to snooze during a 911 call.
No.
That's not just breathing, that's snoring. Around 12:30 in the morning, a call came in from this apartment complex to Montgomery County, Maryland, fire and rescue.
Fire and ambulance.
Hello? Hello?
The dispatcher apparently nods off.
Hold on a second, man. Let me try and get them on the line again.
A second dispatcher takes over, but the sleeping one remains on the line as the caller reports her husband is apparently unconscious.
But right now he's all blue.
But the snoring confuses the second dispatcher, who mistakes it for the victim having trouble breathing.
And tilts his head back.
Yes. Uh-huh.
Okay. Is that him I hear doing that snoring noises?
Yes.
Okay. Are you able to keep that airway open like that? I see the snoring noises stop.
Not for long.
Is the blueness going away?
To me, it looks not good to me.
You can actually hear the dispatcher snore maybe 17 or 18 times during the course of the 911 call. According to Deputy Fire Chief Scott Graham.
In my 24 years here, this is the only incident that I can recall where a dispatcher has fallen asleep on a 911 call.
Oh, I don't know what to do.
Okay, ma'am, is he still making the snoring noises?
Yeah, a little bit, but he's like... He stopped breathing for a little while.
It turns out the sleeping firefighter was 17 hours into his shift.
He was about 20 minutes away from going into his rest period.
Now he's on paid administrative leave. As for the patient...
Oh, he's blue again.
The deputy chief says the incident had no adverse impact on the victim's condition. About 5.5 minutes into the call, the sleeping dispatcher wakes up, picking up where he left off. He mutters a question...
What's the address?
Uh-huh.
Ma'am, what's the address?
Who knew 911 needed a wake-up call? Jeanne Moos, CNN.
Yes. Uh-huh.
New York.